Do we talk to David about the two goals and how important they were for him?
Yeah, they were nice. You know, Blake made two great passes to me, you know, one on the, both on the power play, and they're pretty much tap-ins for me, so, yeah.
Go back to that second goal where you kind of one-timed it there. Obviously, that's one of the options that you're looking for on the power play. Did you see that coming prior to it actually happening?
You know, I thought Blake was going to shoot the puck, but then he made a nice little backhand pass and got all the attention to him, and I was left a lot of time and space, and I just one-timed it. So, yeah, it was a good play on his part.
What needs to happen differently tonight compared to what we did against Northern to beat a very good Minnesota-Duluth team?
We need, against Northern, we didn't come out and play, you know, right off the bat. I think we need to come out and play, you know, shut down their top line and get the puck in behind them and bang the D around a little bit.
Good luck tonight, David.
Thank you.
All right, David Johnstone talking to us just a little bit ago about his two goals and the one reason why he was being a little bit distracted during that interview. Blake Pietola seems to find it very funny to try to distract his fellow freshman during other interviews. We talked to Coach Sandlin about this series against Alabama Huntsville. You look at it on paper, it's a team that's not supposed to give you fits, but they did give you fits, and his thoughts on that game.
Well, everyone seems to think so. You know, again, you know, I've said it a number of times. There are no easy games in college hockey, no matter what anybody thinks. I think the critical thing was we got two wins, and I thought the Saturday game for both teams was better. Got to give a lot of credit to their team. They played a very good team game. Their goalie was good, and, you know, but we did enough, and, you know, we had some areas that we need to get better at, and, you know, certainly we worked on those this week, so hopefully they're better. But, you know, in this part of the year, everyone gets better, and the games, there's no easy games. So bottom line is we got out of it with two wins, and we're looking forward to this weekend.
Your defense is doing such a good job of helping out with the scoring this year, I think third or fourth in the nation. How much has that lent to you guys your success this year, having the defense put in some points?
Well, I think you always need some contributions back there. Last year we had a couple guys in Falk and Montgomery that, were certainly a big part of that. We're able to get up the rink, and, you know, we try and do that with our defense and try and activate them a little bit, You know, some of those are power play points, obviously, but, you know, it's nice to get those guys chipping in here and there and contributing offensively, of course. But I think probably the biggest thing for us has been, you know, some of the other forwards contributing all year. I think you look at our stats and, you know, a lot of guys have goals and we've had different guys chip in here and there. And it's not just been, you know, certainly one line like maybe last year or two lines. But, you know, we certainly have two good lines, but I like our depth, and the balance of scoring has really helped us do what we've done.
And does that loosen things up for guys like Connolly and his line out there? Because obviously, especially on the road, when you don't have that last change, they have to look at every line out there, not just him.
Yeah, you know, I mean, they're certainly still, I mean, I think we all know they're going to pay attention to our, you know, our top guys. I mean, every team does, and but, you know, I think, you know, those guys still have found ways, which has been good. You know, our 5-on-5 scoring has been good. Our power play has been average, you know, so which is a little bit unlike last year. But hopefully we can get that going. But, you know, you hope it takes a little pressure off when other guys chip in. You know, it's nice to see here and there. But, you know, I think the other thing, too, that I didn't mention is, you know, our best players have been our best players. And I think that's certainly a tribute to what they've done so far, too, which has helped.
So where are we sitting now on the season, where you guys are sitting, as besides wanting to win the next game that you're always playing, do you have an immediate goal as far as a team goal? Is it to win the league? You know, what is it?
No, we haven't talked about that. You know what? I just always believe that, you know, certainly in our league, you never look too far ahead and you don't look behind. We talked on Monday, you know, the streak was great. You know, I mean, it's put us in a good position, but that's not what you play for. You know, you play to keep getting better so that you're playing your best hockey going into the final month and, you know, which we're coming up upon and into the playoffs. So we've still got some work to do. There's no question. And, you know, it's nice to get back into, you know, league play again here. You know, we've got a couple non-conference series sandwiched with one league series, so it's nice to play every weekend here on out against teams in our league because we've got a tough schedule and it's going to force us to either get better or stay the same.
I know you've answered a lot of questions on Jack, but one more question, Coach. You've mentioned that he is better this year. What, in what way is he better this year?
Well, I think number one, I think he's matured so much as a leader. I think there was a lot of questions. I think even he had questions. When you play with a couple guys for as long as he did, you know, there's always like, how's it going to be? And I think he's just he started the year maybe thinking that way, but I think after about the first month when we did switch some lines, I think that's when he really started to excel. And I think he kind of, going back to that leadership thing, I think he took that upon himself to be ready to play and do the things a good captain does and a good player does, and that's lead our team. And I think we saw it up at your place for two periods. He you guys shut him down pretty good, but he found a way in the third period. So, even if he's not scoring, I think he's still, a threat on the ice, and I think that's a compliment to him. But, certainly he's – I think it changes your game a little bit when you have to learn to play with different players, and he's adapted well and made the others around him better.
Well, we talked to Coach about the shots on goal against Duluth in the last series back at the John McGinnis Student Ice Arena in early December. Huskies – shot 57 times on goal, but did not come away with any victories. And we asked Coach, against a team like Minnesota Duluth, is 57 shots in a two-game series enough?
Well, it's enough shots, but that's not how you measure the game. It's how many get by him. So, we had some quality shots. I thought he played well when he's in Houghton. He's a very good goalie. He's won a national championship. He's proved he can win. And he's playing with a lot of confidence this year. So we're going to have to get traffic and continue to get the puck to the net, and hopefully good things will happen.
Bulldogs obviously were good when we played them in early December. As you look at them, what they've done since then, do you feel they're a better team now than even back when we played them?
I really do, because they got off to a tough start there. They lost three of their first four, and when we saw them, they were playing pretty well. But I thought we had two excellent games with them, but watching the tape of the last few games, they went down to Western Michigan and beat a very good Western Michigan team on the road, went into Omaha, and they split, but even the second game, they outshot Omaha, I think, 47-15. So they're playing extremely well. They've got their confidence going now, and I think they've got their freshmen. They're not freshmen anymore, and they play a big role on their team.
We didn't have a very good start against Northern Michigan. I guess it goes without saying that that's a crucial point going into this game, that we start well.
Well, yeah, we can't keep playing from behind. We put ourselves in the hole against Northern, and we fought our way back, but it takes a lot of energy out of you to fight all the way back like we did. So against a team like Minnesota Duluth, you're not going to get many goals probably anyway. So you have to get off to a good start and play a good road game, limit their scoring chances, get good goaltending, and then take advantage of your scoring opportunities.
David Johnston, with a couple of power play goals last weekend, ended up with five shots on goal in that Northern game. Is he the type of guy that we just need to keep feeding the puck to?
Well, the way he shoots it, no question, and he's got to shoot it more, shoot it quicker, get the puck away quicker, and then hit the net. Every time he releases a puck, he's got a chance to score. Like, he's a scorer. Like I told you maybe earlier in the year, some guys just shoot it, and some guys shoot to score, and then David shoots to score. So good for him. It's good to see him get a little confidence, and we need him to have a good second half for us, and hopefully that will give the confidence to have a real solid second half.
What are the biggest differences in the way we attack UMD versus the way we attack a team like Northern Michigan?
Well, it won't be much different. We'll play aggressive. We'll go after them a little bit. I think, the thing that I noticed is we seem to play better against the top teams in the league, because they come in and try and beat you. And when we play that style, it seems like it suits our team better, the way we're playing more aggressive. We're playing the teams a trap a little bit more. It's a little more difficult for us to get through the trap. So we'll play the same way. We'll be aggressive. We'll put some pressure on their defensemen, try and create turnovers, and then we have to take advantage of that.
And, Coach, a couple of big-time family members of the Husky hockey family passing away in the past couple of weeks, and one of them being Bruce Ryuta.
Well, yeah, Bruce is, I got to know Bruce real well, a great guy, great man, and obviously we had his son Barry at Michigan Tech when I was coaching there, so our prayers and thoughts go out to the Ryuta family on the passing of Bruce.
And Mr. Trudell, a big-time supporter of Michigan Tech hockey for a long, long time.
Yeah, Ron was a real big supporter. I know just recently, the Christmas break, he had a number of our players over for a
dinner. Yeah, Coach Mel Pearson went on to talk about Ron Trudell, who passed away, and having the kids over for dinner, and just a great Michigan Tech guy, football, hockey, whatever it was. Loved having him at the Blue Line luncheons, and and he'll be missed. And, of course, Bruce Ryuta, just a great ambassador, not just for Michigan Tech, but for hockey in general. And his passing is just much too soon, 67 years old. And, again, from all of us here at Mix 93, and, of course, the Sports Information Department over at Michigan Tech, thoughts and prayers to the families of both of those family members of Michigan Tech hockey. I guess that's the best way you can put it, Wes.